Hi and welcome to another RACOM tutorial. Today, I would like to continue our series of Ray videos with a basic link setup tutorial. As we said in our power-up tutorial, we recommend performing basic setup of the link in a lab to prevent any issues from occurring later in the field. There are three areas we need to explore: radio, service networking, and security. To follow the method in this tutorial yourself, you will need a railing consisting of two units in factory settings and two power supplies of your choice and a computer. Now let's start. First, we need to connect to the web admin interface. In case you're not sure how to connect units to the power and access its web interface, please refer to our power-up tutorial. Every powered-up Ray pair automatically tries to establish a radio link, which can be achieved without any antennas, for example on the table or even inside their shipping boxes, as shown in our power-up tutorial. This allows you to configure both sides of the link at the same time from a single admin website window. Now first, let's look at radio interface parameters. These radio settings are supposed to be used as pre-configuration for the field installation. We recommend doing the final settings when units are installed and the antennas are aligned. There are four key parameters required to form a radio link: TX and RX channel, TX and RX bandwidth, maximum and minimum ACM modulation, and TX power. All of them can be found in link settings on tab Radio Parameters. You always see the unit you are connected to on the left and the remote peer unit on the right. We recommend keeping bandwidth and ACM maximum and minimum modulation in default to get the best system gain and thus the easiest connection later while aligning the antenna. In case you work in license bands, you should set your RX and TX channels and TX power according to your license. In case of license-free bands, you might have performed a site survey. If so, you know which channels and TX power you will be using. Otherwise, leave defaults there as well. You can learn more about practical wireless settings in our other tutorial videos. Once wireless parameters are set, let's apply them and we can move on to setting the service networking up. Let's go to Link Settings, Service Access, Services tab first. Here, I need to set management IP addresses of both units, their netmasks and gateways. I will set 10, 15, 16, 10 to my local unit and 10, 15, 16, 11 to the peer, both using the default netmask. My gateway is on 10, 15, 16, 1 and this setting is usually shared between the units. It is recommended to use VLANs for service access to further strengthen security. Please double-check these settings to make sure you will be able to access the unit remotely when it's installed. This action will log you out of the unit. Since we're using Wi-Fi service connection, you only need to refresh the page and log in again. With service networking out of the way, let's focus on security now. It is essential to change the default passwords, so let's go to the Users tab and set a secure admin password by clicking the Edit button. Should you like to use the same password on both units, you can simply click the Mirror Users button at the bottom of the screen to override peer units' user accounts. Let's do it now. The last tab we have not visited yet is USB accessories, where we need to secure the service Wi-Fi by inputting passphrases for both units. You can set both at the same time by clicking Apply only after both passphrases are typed in. So let's do that now. This action will disconnect you from Wi-Fi and I will use this opportunity to power cycle both units by disconnecting power for a few seconds. This routine step makes sure no omissions were made during initial configuration. Now, let's reconnect the power and wait for interchanging green and LED status lights, indicating both units have booted up. Just so you know, the red light will stop when you deactivate service Wi-Fi after installation. Now, I will reconnect by using the admin password I set previously. On status page, we will check the link status in the top red bar and review all the settings we have just made. This is all you need to do to prepare a link for alignment. There are many more features described in detail in our manual and other advanced tutorial videos. If you were interested in improving your RAI skills, I would recommend reviewing those. RAI truly is a powerhouse. And that is all for today. Please stay tuned for our RAI installation video, which will conclude our RAI journey from unboxing to installation of the link. Please subscribe to our channel so you don't miss new tutorials and tips. Thank you and have a great day.